everyone, it's Christina.
And I'm Geraldine.
And today on this episode, we're talking about hair growth. I would say that hair growth is one of the top searched phrases of all time on Naturally Curly. Everyone wants to know how to grow their hair. When people ask me what they can do to make their hair grow, what people are asking is like, what products can I use? What can I put on my scalp? What pills can I take? But my first line of defense is always, are you drinking enough water? Do you have a good healthy diet? Are you only sleeping 4 hours a night? Because all of those things, if you're very stressed, those are contributing to your hair growth probably more than any product that you're gonna apply onto your hair is going to.
No matter if you're wavy, curly, coily, there are a whole lot of different factors as to why your hair won't grow.
Or why you think your hair is not growing. So we know it can be super frustrating when it's been like 6 months and it seems like your hair is still the same length. So today we're gonna talk about the science of why it seems like your hair isn't growing and some tips on how to change that.
One of the many reasons your hair probably seems like it's not growing is because you're probably suffering from breakage. Breakage is when your hair just starts kind of breaking off and just kind of looks like little hair strands are everywhere. It's super important that you keep the ends of your hair super healthy by locking in hydration and moisturizing them, because otherwise, if you don't take care of the ends of your hair, they're just gonna start breaking off, they'll start splitting. It's gonna be a really bad scene for you. So another key factor for you to have awesome hair that does not fall out, that keeps growing the way that it's supposed to, is scalp health. You have to keep your scalp healthy, you have to keep it stimulated, and you have to keep it free from product buildup and debris. The best ways to do that is to take any one of your favorite like hair oils or even a co-wash, a cleanser, and get to the scalp. And you just massage it real nice like, rinse it out, and you will clear your scalp of all that nasty stuff that it doesn't need.
When you're giving yourself a scalp massage, it's important not to use your nails. You're really wanting to use the pads of your fingers, and it's helping the blood flow. Also, it's important to cleanse your scalp well. I know in the curly world, we try not to shampoo or shampoo as little as possible, but shampoo can play a really important role in removing product buildup.
Clarifying shampoo, a clarifying treatment. You wanna make sure that that scalp is ready to receive whatever else you need to put on it for styling and for maintenance.
And there are a lot of natural oils that have really great properties for your scalp that will stimulate your scalp. They're antifungal, antimicrobial. We have a list down below of the different oils that are good for your scalp, but a lot of the popular ones are like peppermint, tea tree oil, eucalyptus.
Love those.
Something else that's going to really increase the breakage that you're experiencing and also just hurt your hair health is heat styling. The heat zaps all the moisture out of your hair and it creates permanent damage that it's irreversible. A lot of people will talk about bringing their hair back from heat damage, but eventually you're just going to have to cut that off. A lot of people don't want to get trims or cut their hair because they're like, I'm growing my hair right now, I don't want to cut any of it off.
You need to make room for all of the new growth and the healthy hair. It's not gonna do anything if you keep all that dead, nasty,
the wispy,
breaking stuff on there. Yeah, you gotta get rid of it. You gotta cut it.
Get a trim.
So whenever you do your blowout at home, make sure that you're using a thermal protecting sealant so that when you're working all that heat down the strands, it's not causing a lot of damage. There might be a little bit, but you want to prevent it as best as you can.
Yeah, something that's specifically formulated to protect your hair from heat. I would not recommend using like an oil as your heat protectant because those have smoke points where the oil is just gonna burn right off.
Also, if you're noticing that your hair is falling out in patches, something's going on with your scalp, you have to go to a dermatologist, you have to go to a trichologist, someone that can actually diagnose whatever is going on with your scalp. There's no article in the world that can tell you what's happening with your hair if there's some serious issues that are visible to you.
Shedding is normal. It's part of the hair growth cycle. So all hair will come out at some point. It's not anything to be worried about. Most people lose about 100 hairs a day.
But shedding is a little bit different. Shedding starts right here at the scalp. So it's as if one of your hair strands well, one of your hair strands will fall out and it'll have the little bulb still attached to it. That's shedding, that's not breakage.
But I think with curly hair especially, you don't really shed that hair until you get in the shower. So mm-hmm. if you only wash your hair once every 5 days, then you might get 500 hairs trying to go down your drain and think that you're having a hair loss problem. But it's just that that shed hair doesn't fall from your head the way it does with straight hair. So also keep that in mind. Yeah, and we also have an article that's like all the different signs that you need to go see a trichologist. So we'll put that in description below too. So if you really think that your hair is not growing, that there's something going on, you should definitely see a medical practitioner.
And no matter what your texture type is, what your curl pattern is, I highly recommend getting rid of those cotton pillowcases. You need satin or silk. If you like wrapping your hair at night, satin or silk bonnets, satin or silk scarves, anything to help your hair not get pulled and tussled about by cotton that can cause breakage overnight.
If you have questions for us about why your hair is not growing, let us know down in the comments. We'll try to get back to you.
And the next time you see us, we're gonna come back to answer your question about why your hair is always dry. So we'll see you soon.
Bye.